Hello friends, welcome again. Today we will discuss about the female reproductive system. Female reproductive system is consists of primary sex organs and secondary sex organs. So what are these primary sex organs and secondary sex organs? Today we will discuss about all these organs one by one. So friends, let's start. In this diagram, you can see this is the structure of female reproductive system, and it consists of different types of organs. So basically, what are the organs of a female reproductive system? So friends, here you can see these are the ovaries, which are paired. So these paired ovaries, these fallopian tubes and uterus, vagina and external genitalia. These all organs make the female reproductive system. So let's start one by one all of these organs. These are the paired ovaries. These paired ovaries are basically situated at the lower portion of the abdomen, and these ovaries are very important organs because these are primary sex organs. Why we are called them primary sex organs? Because these are the site where the egg is produced inside the female. So this is the primary sex organ. These are paired in these are paired in number, and ovary are basically solid in nature. Why? Because it is basically made up of externally by the cortical stroma and internally by the medullary region. That's why it is solid in nature. And ovary is held at their position with the help of these three ligaments. These three ligaments are very important ligaments because with the help of these ligaments, ovary is present, ovary is situated at their site. So suspensory ligament is a ligament with the help of which ovary is attached to the lateral wall of the pelvic girdle. And ovarian ligament is a ligament with the help of which ovary is attached with the lateral wall of the uterus. And a broad ligament is a ligament with the help of which ovary is attached to the lower portion of the abdominal wall. So basically, broad ligament is a double fold of peritoneum, which is also called mesoovarium. Here you can see this is a mesoovarium. It is basically a double fold of peritoneum, or also called broad ligament, with the help of which ovary is attached to the lateral wall of the abdomen. And friends, you can see this is the uterus where the implantation of egg is occur, and where the implantation of fetus is occur. And uterus is and from the uterus arises two canal. These ducts are called fallopian tubes, and because these are arise from the uterus, that's why these are also called uterine duct, or we can also call them oviduct. These oviduct are basically consist of three portions. One portion is infundibulum, which is near towards the ovary, and behind the infundibulum there is another portion which is called ampulla, and behind the ampulla there is a isthmus. Isthmus and ampulla, there is a junction where the fertilization of egg is occur. And infundibulum is a infundibulum make the accessory duct of the female reproductive system. And in front here you can see some finger like projections. These finger like projections are called fimbriae, and these are the openings, small openings, which are called ostia. Why these finger like projections are present here? Because these finger like projections help in catching the ova from the ovary and help them transport toward the uterus. With the help of these oviduct, the ova which catched from the ovary transport toward the uterus. So friends, here you can see this is a uterus portion, and uterus is basically further consist of three portion. Upper portion is fundus, which is a dome shape portion, and another portion is corpus, and corpus is a portion where the implantation occur, and cervix is another portion which have a canal which is called a cervical canal. So friends, uterus is very important part of the body of the female reproductive system. Friends, uterus is also called, this is a uterus, and uterus is also called womb or hyster. Another important structure you can see here, this is the mesosalpinx. Mesosalpinx is basically a double fold of peritoneum which help in the attachment, or which help in the fallopian tube to held in their position. So mesosalpinx is also very important structure. And the a mesentery is present all over the uterus, which is called mesentery is present all over the uterus. And mesentery in combination with the mesoovarium and mesosalpinx form the mesometrium. So here you can see that the oviduct or fallopian tube is approximately 10 to 12 centimeter. And friends, one important thing that uterus is, this is the uterus, and uterus is made up of three lines, three layers. Outer layer is peritoneum layer, which is mesodermal in origin and which is thin or membranous layer. Inside the peritoneum, there is another layer which is called myometrium, which is also mesodermal in origin, but myometrium is thick in nature. And inside the myometrium, there is endometrium. This is the inner lining of the uterus, which is called endometrium. Endometrium is basically glandular in nature, and two-third part of the endometrium is a structural functionale, which is slugged during the menstrual cycle. Friends, in this diagram, you can also see internal os and external os. So this is the cervical canal or a cavity of the cervix, and it is separate from the corpus portion of the uterus with the help of internal os. And this cervical canal separate from the vagina with the help of external os. So os are basically the sphincter of the female reproductive system. And below the cervix, there is a vagina. Vagina is also have a cavity which is called vaginal canal. And vaginal canal and cervical canal both make the birth canal. So friends, this is the vaginal canal. Vagina is basically the non-glandular portion of the female reproductive system. These lining or this inner lining of the vagina is basically the non-keratinized stratified squamous epithelium. So the vaginal opening is called a vulva. This is the structure of vulva. Vulva, or we can also say that the structure guarded the vaginal opening is called pudendum or external genitalia. So friends, in this diagram, you can see these are the structure of vulva. Vulva basically consists of labia majora. Labia majora are upper folds or upper lips, and this is the labia minora. Labia minora are basically hidden by the labia majora. At the upper portion of the labia majora, there is a elevated fleshy structure which is covered by hair. You can see these are the hairs, and these hairs or these fleshy elevated structure is called mons pubis. And another fleshy, this is a labia minora. At the upper portion of the labia minora, there is a small erectile tissue which is called clitoris, and it is a very sensitive structure. It is a small erectile tissue which is very sensitive because all the nerves ends here, which are sensitive for touch and pressure. Friends, in this diagram, you can see that inside the labia minora, there are a upper portion which is called urethral opening from where the urine passes out, and this is a vaginal opening from where the menstrual blood coming out, and this is a vaginal discharge also occur there. This is called vaginal opening, and vaginal opening is basically covered by a temporary membrane which is called hymen. So hymen is also a very important structure, and it is a temporary structure, temporary membrane. And you can see this is a forceti. Forceti is basically also called frenulum, where the labia minora meets posteriorly. And you can see that this clitoris is present dorsally inside the female reproductive system. So this was all about the female reproductive structure externally, where the ovary produced the egg, which are very important for fertilization and for implantation. For implantation, there is a site inside the female reproductive system, which is a uterus, which are inverted P-shaped like structure. And fallopian tube help in the transportation of the female reproductive help in the transportation of the egg from the ovary towards the uterus for implantation. Cervical canal and vaginal canal both form the birth canal. And endometrium is the inner lining of the uterus, which is glandular in nature and which is slugged during and two-third portion of which is slugged during the menstrual cycle. And vaginal opening and urethral opening both form the vulva of the female reproductive system. So female reproductive system is very important because primary structure involved in the egg production. So thank you, friends. I hope you will like this video. If you don't forget to subscribe my channel. Thank you, friends.